The responsibility we were charged with was to ensure that the LRT coming through the city would have a meaningful relationship with every community that it goes through. The design of the project started with a realization that we were influencing something that would go right across the city. We looked historically into the city to be inspired by something that would move across the city. And the first image we looked at was the historic railroad. And Calgary was built because of the railroad. And the railroad engine, the image of the railroad engine coming across the prairie, inspired me to think of not only the connection to Calgary's origins, but also to the plume of the engine itself and the energy that represents and what that means to people as something that is memorable. The second image we looked at, which is absolutely about this place, is the Chinook. The Chinook coming across as a flat plane of cloud compresses the sunlight and forces it into very dramatic shadows on the landscape. So that affects our architecture and how we make buildings, but it also affects your sense of place because of the way, again, the sun works with the light. And so I'm very interested that it's formed by wind and by moisture, but it's light that brings it to life. And so that's the second image. The third image is an art piece by a famous art team of Christo and Jean-Claude, and in 1974 they built the running fence on the Sonoma landscape in California. It for me was the next level of how to take something either natural like the Chinook cloud or arguably man-made like the steam plume and manifest that something into something that we build. And so the plume to the Chinook arch to the waving fabric influence what I think the building should be like as we build the infrastructure for the Green Line across the Calgary landscape. My goal is that we can create a consistent pattern of building that starts from one end of Calgary, in the southeast, and moves all the way up ultimately to the very north end of the city.
We developed a kit of parts, and it was very important to us that we apply it not only to the stations and the canopies, but to some of the elements that would be on the platforms or the poles that support the OCS wires or the pedestrian poles. Because most of the stations, it's not just merely the station. You have the plaza areas, you have park and ride, you have bus terminals. So you have many, many elements that are placed in and around the stations, and we wanted to make sure that we had that link. But also when we're going to be procuring that many poles or that many elements, it makes a lot of sense to design them efficiently and in a way that they can easily replicate it.
What's important to me is that we have used these parts to inform every station particularly, and each one is different. We see the transit plaza as being the threshold or the porch or veranda between the station and the community or the neighborhood. And so the transit plaza will be something that each community can shape into their own expression within the context of the larger expression of this consistent architecture. Some neighborhoods will be more historic, some neighborhoods will be more contemporary, and everything in between, but the transit plaza will be the device that the communities can embrace to make the station their own.
So a lot of the work that we did on previous station workshops with the communities was to introduce the idea of the plazas. Each of the stations has a plaza that's a significant space for their community. And it was very important that they have potential for a variety of uses. So maybe, you know, Monday to Friday, they're primarily directed to transit users and people passing through them. But on a Saturday or Sunday, is there a space that's available for a farmer's market or even a pop-up food trucks or some of those other uses, or are there other uses that the community would like these spaces for? For each of the stations, the majority of stations are at-grade stations, and they are side-loaded platforms. But as well, we have a couple of stations that are elevated stations, and then in the downtown, we have four below-grade stations. So most of the elements on day one are fairly small scale, but as we grow or as the additional ridership comes in or additional development comes around the stations, then the coverage of the canopies can be added to. Part of what we've done with the design of the stations in concert with the architectural design is to really think about how to keep the platforms very open. And of course there's the requisite number of shelters and benches, but they'll probably have a much more cleaner, uncluttered, sort of seamless look to them. And the other aspect of this project, of course, that has been talked about before is the fact that we are low floor platforms. So we don't have the need for very long ramps or those connections on the back of the plazas, which are attached to the station platforms. You'll have sort of a seamless connection, so you'll be able to walk through from the plazas directly onto the platforms.